Dear friends of the Tom Photo channel and all new viewers, different people have different ways of going about their photography and handling and organizing their photos, in the hope that you're interested and would like to compare it against your own ideas. I'd like to tell you about my photography workflow. What are the steps I take to get from the click to the final photo, and what's in between? I should say that I mostly do landscape photography. Let's start from the beginning. I use tripod whenever possible. But the first more interesting question is the age-old JPEG versus RAW file, one or both? My default setting is both, and this is why. Although I often end up needing the RAW version of my shot, I initially work with the JPEG. JPEG gives me three major advantages, even if I don't want to eventually keep that JPEG. First, it serves as an index of my photo shoot. I look at the JPEGs to decide which corresponding RAW files I want to keep. Going through JPEGs is much faster than RAW files. Second, I do my automated photo quality measurements on the JPEG to decide the quality of the corresponding shot. And third, when working up RAW files, the outcome needs to be better than the JPEG was, otherwise there's no point. So the JPEG serves as a quality reference, and it may turn out that the JPEG is better than what I got out of my RAW file. As the second major point, I take at least two shots of the exact same scene, even when shooting from the tripod and using exactly the same settings. Slightly different focusing and a possible camera shake will make sure that one photo is better than the other. One photo may have a better composition or better light. Often you can reach the verdict which is better by zooming in and eyeballing. When the images look exactly the same, I don't assess their sharpness manually, but I run my Python script to automatically generate sharpness values for all images in the folder. I have previously presented this script, please see the link below. Now I know which JPEG RAW file pair is the best to keep. For the images that already look good as JPEGs, I typically do not additionally produce new versions from RAW files. For these, I use only GIMP to give some final touches. So most of my final products, maybe 75% of the photos, are actually retouched JPEG files. When the JPEG is not perfect, I use RawTherapee to work up the RAW files. This is the time-consuming part. However, with similar images, I make a RAW file template and automatically run through many images at once. When I get the corresponding RawTherapee automation tutorial ready, I'll post it below. My introductory RawTherapee course is already listed below. My RawTherapee output is a TIFF file. Why? Because I like to give my files a final touch in GIMP, and TIFF is better than JPEG to carry the info from RawTherapee to GIMP. Why I need GIMP is highly specific to me. You can do so much in RawTherapee that you really don't need GIMP. But I like the lens distortion and sharpening functions and perhaps some other functions in GIMP a little bit better. My GIMP image sharpening tutorial is below too. RawTherapee also outputs a PP3 file. This holds the settings used to work up the RAW file. I will store this file next to my RAW file, and I don't throw it away. You'll soon see why. So regardless of the initial source, I give my JPEG file the final touches in GIMP and store the output as JPEG file using quality setting 96. I think any setting between 95 and 98 is a good choice. Note that many photographers would now output the photo in TIFF format and delete the JPEG and the RAW file, because their clients are likely to request the TIFF file. I do exactly the opposite. I keep the JPEG, RAW, and the PP3 file. Why? The TIFF takes an enormous amount of space, in my case over 100 megabytes each. This is more than I like. JPEG is small and usable for most purposes. RAW file is one-third of the TIFF in size, and I store it together with the corresponding PP3 file. If the client wants a TIFF from me, I'll make it again from the RAW file, using the info stored in the PP3 file. True that I have to redo the GIMP steps then, however it doesn't happen too often that someone wants to get a tip from me. If this happens, I'm willing to invest the 5 minutes again to make the diff, but, and this but is underlined, I now additionally have the option to make a different looking TIFF to meet the client's needs even better. The best part is that unlike TIFFs, the RAW files can be compressed when stored, so it's not a bad file for long-term storage, and you'll still have all the flexibility. I should add that I only store a RAW file for the best images. For most casual photos, I only keep JPEG. Now, how do I store my photos? I have an automatic script that renames all of my photos according to the time and date the photo was taken. This is the best ID there is. For each year, I have 12 folders to store the photos, one for each month. Each folder has subfolders for the individual photo shoots, and they have descriptive names such as morning fog 2 kilometers north from home near a beach. So the folder names become searchable. And the most important thing is that I have 2 copies of each folder, residing on different external hard drives. If one hard drive becomes bad, I'll make another copy using the good hard drive. I use 2 terabyte hard drives. To store 2 terabytes of photos, I therefore need 4 terabytes of storage. As you see, I use a very simple system. I steer clear of commercial photo storage solutions. I basically simply copy and paste files. My computational system is Ubuntu Linux. I like the flexibility and speed it gives me. On the other hand, there are some tools that may not run on Linux, but I don't use those. Looking forward to the discussion in the comments to read about your workflow. If you like this video, please consider pressing the subscribe button. That would make me happy. Thanks so much for watching. I'm looking forward to seeing you in my future and past videos. Have a wonderful day.